24 hours, I need more hours with you. You spent the weekend getting even, ooh. We spent the late nights making things right between us. But now it's all good, babe. Roll that backwood, babe, and play me close. Cause girls like you run around with guys like me till sundown when I come.
What's up, guys? It's your boy OJ from OJ&Eli TV. So today, me and Ellie decided to do something a bit different. Well, we go to college at Fmcc, better known as Fulton Montgomery Community College, upstate New York, located in Johnstown, New York, 12095. Anyways, so we thought about doing it a little different, and we did an interview with one of our favorite advisor or faculty member or something. Anyway, so we thought it was a good idea to interview somebody who was in the college for a good while, who we know and who we trust to talk to and get like straightforward answers and what's not. So I interviewed her, and a lot of things that she says was very insightful. And I hope that you who view in this video, who think gonna go to college after you graduate high school, or want to go to college after you graduate high school, hope you enjoy this video and get some information that you needed to know. And as I said, I'm going to say it now. I'm going to post the email to the person who I spoke to. She is the coordinator for student activities on campus. So anything from clubs to events on campus you want to know, she's the person you can go to. You want to start a club and be a new standing club at college, you can also check her out, and she will give you the detail of what you need to do, your requirements, and all that. It's good. Enjoy the video. Good afternoon to all my YouTube viewers who are taking a way to college. This is FMCC, aka Fulton Montgomery Community College. I'm here with Student Activities Board Director Gwendolyn Osenka. So I'm basically gonna ask her like questions, like basic questions that college students, like pre-college students, would ask before coming to college.
Okay.
So my first question is, from the time that you went to college, in terms of having diversity in a campus, how has it changed from then to now?
So I came here in 1999. I know that's a long time ago. So I graduated Gloversville High School and came here after that. So when I was here, I'll be honest with you guys, a commuter student, so I wasn't really into activities or kind of what was going on campus. I came here and also had a part-time job, but from what I remember, we had a large group of students from, I believe it was over 30 different countries, and back then it could have been even more. Now we have a much smaller amount of students from different countries. I think we're around 8 or 9, but I could be wrong on that. When I was here, when I was a college student, we didn't own the dorms. So there was only 2 dorms there, and they were owned by a private company. I don't really remember, I remember diversity here on this campus, but to be honest with you, when I was a college student, I just kind of came here, did what I needed to do, and left. So it's hard for me to answer that question.
This is not really a part of one of the questions. It might be a sidebar to the first question, but I'm wondering, like, do you think that if they had dorms back then, they would still have diverse students, like, coming up to, like, an increasing amount? Or would it still be decreasing?
Well, I think that there's a lot of, you know, when we talk about diversity, in my mind, I feel like there's a lot of different avenues that play into it. You know, we're not just talking about skin color. We're talking about diversity as far as beliefs, of a way of life, religion, all of that. So I think, You know, had we owned the dorms back then, do I think that we would have had more diverse students? I don't really know. Probably. I mean, as far as like students coming from outside of the area, but I don't know. That's kind of a hard question to answer, I think, because you know our student body has changed so much. Again, back then, I mean, I was 18 years old, so you know, I wasn't really thinking about things like that as far as like kind of looking around in my classes, but I don't really remember very many returning adult students in any of my classes. And of course it could have been the major, but you know, I don't really remember that, where today in this position I feel like we have a large number of returning adult students. So I mean, that's diversity too, right?
The question number two, which is when you first went to college, that period between starting and finishing,
mm-hmm.
how did you feel becoming a freshman versus how you felt being a senior mm-hmm. after the whole transition from freshman to senior?
Mm-hmm. So I was terrified. So one of the cool things about coming here was that I came here when I was really little. My grandmother worked here. So she worked over in the Student Development Center. So I spent a lot of summers here. So as far as feeling comfortable with the actual buildings and where I was going, that wasn't a problem. But starting classes terrified me. I was always a BC student. I was never really, you know, a great student. I wasn't bad by any means. But, you know, sometimes there's students who it just comes naturally to them in academics, and I definitely was not one of those students. So for me, it was a struggle to, you know, get those good grades and realize the difference between high school and college, which was really difficult because, you know, all of a sudden you had these syllabuses, which I'd never even heard of before that. My father doesn't have a college education. My mom has a bachelor's, but, you know, a college was never one of those things that was an absolute for me, I guess. I knew I was going to college because I, you know, in the back of my head, I knew that was the right thing to do, but didn't really have anybody there kind of helping me with staying on track and telling me what college should look like or what I should be doing. So it was terrifying, which is one reason why I came here, because I knew I wasn't ready to go away to a four-year college yet. But, you know, I got through it and had friends here, and we all kind of helped each other, and it was kind of, okay, that's how it's. You know, and by my second year, I think I had a pretty good grounding to the point where I actually left a semester early and went up to Plattsburgh and felt comfortable doing that and was well on my way to be a good student. So you know, college is an excellent avenue for students who, one, may not be sure of what they want to do, two, may not be sure to be completely successful. And it really helped me gain that stability and feeling like I was okay to go on.
This will be the last question of the evening.
Okay.
Besides academic, what are some things that new students who come to FM can expect?
Mm-hmm. So here at FM, we have about 30 active clubs, which are very well attended by our students. And those clubs range from anywhere from Student Nurses Association, so if there's a student who maybe isn't in the nursing program but wants to be a nurse someday and wants to know kind of the ins and outs of that program, they can join that club. We have the Student Activities Board, which is for students who maybe you're the party planner of your friends, and you know, when your friends get together, they're like, what are we going to do? And you're the one that they look to. This would be a great club for that sort of student because we plan all of the big events on campus. There's no GPA requirement to join any of the clubs. We have activities on campus this year. Student Activities Board did activities every Tuesday and Thursday. So through the whole 15 weeks of the semester, there's a large activity that happens every Tuesday and Thursday. We have speakers on campus. We take off-campus trips. Mostly all of this is free to students because it's through the student activity fee. But other than that, you know, if there's an activity that a student wants to see on campus, all they have to do is come down to my office and let me know, and we plan it.
Okay. So that's all the questions in this video. And if you need information about FMCC, it's all the clubs, activities that happen on campus. For new students who want to be a part of something
fun,
yeah,
and be engaged in the campus,
I will leave her email in the description below, so you can email her if you have any questions, like, for instance, what type of clubs you'll be interested in, but, like, depends on what you see yourself going towards, especially, like, there's a nursing club. It is,
there's lots of different clubs. There's clubs for nursing if you're interested in being a nurse.
I think Radtech has one, too.
Yep, there's MISA for radiology technology. There's... if you're interested in drama, maybe high school, you perform in the plays here, and they do their own. Your friends come to ask what you're doing this Friday night, and you're the event planner for your friends. We even have a club for that, and we plan all of the big events on campus. So there's really a club for anything that you're interested in. And if there's one that, you know, we don't have, we can always make new clubs.
Anyways, so thank you guys for viewing. Thanks to Gwendolyn Osankop.
You're welcome.
I finally said her name right for the past 2 semesters. 2 years? Wow, she made me feel bad. 2 years. Anyways, so enjoy. Goodbye.
Bye, it's everybody.
It's a boy, OJ.
It's been 24 hours, I need more hours with you. You spent the weekend getting even, ooh. We spent the late nights making things right between us. But now it's all good, babe. Roll that backwood, babe, and play me close. Cause girls like you run around with guys like me till sundown when I